Hi, I'm Dr. Bertice Berry, and I want to tell you a story. I was 15 going on 16, and my high school English teacher, Karen Denton, spoke my dream out loud. "You should go to college," she said. I had no idea that anyone knew that late at night I'd look up at the stars from my uncurtained window in the bedroom that I shared with my siblings, praying that someday I could go to college. College was as far off as those stars. No one in my family had been to college, not my siblings, not my aunts, uncles, nobody. So when she said that thing out loud, it was powerful. It unleashed a desire in me that would not quit. But she didn't just say it. She went about showing me the way. She guided me to the Upward Bound program, a TRIO program designed to help poor and first-generation students go to college. It's one of the TRIO programs. So I enrolled in that program. And from that, I learned that you needed to have some volunteer experience on your resume. Well, I had loads of volunteering, but it was all done with my church. I volunteered to help elders. I volunteered with cleaning. I volunteered with everything with the church. And Karen said, well, you need some outside experience, some diversity, some things that are different from what you typically do. And a lot of times in what is known as the Black church community, we give all of our time, our volunteer time, inside, and we do very little outside of there. So I did. There was a long list in the school guidance counselor's office of places that young people could volunteer, and one stood out for me. It was called the Delaware Youth for the Handicapped, and it was a program that paired up young people from Delaware with people who were differently abled. There were kids with cerebral palsy and Down syndrome, and you name it, multiple sclerosis. There were all kinds of things and people who you were partnered with. And on Saturday, I would catch two buses to go to the designated park where we would all meet and hang out and tell stories and play and do athletic things. And it was amazing. It was the first thing that really got me outside of the things, the sameness that I had experienced. I was interacting in places that I had never been in my little town, Wilmington, Delaware. I was interacting with people that I didn't typically interact with, white people. I had very little interaction, with the exception of my teachers, with white folks. My schools were Black. My neighborhood was Black. It was all this. And what was interesting was in that dynamic, I was not the person that someone was handing something to. In that dynamic, I wasn't the person who was in need. Typically, when young Black folks are interacting with white folks outside of our community, especially inner city kids like that who are poor, we are the person who's being helped, who needs something. And so this dynamic where I was desperately needed, but also I needed them, it changed the game. It changed the tables. It turned the tables around. It enabled me to understand that being poor, being Black, being inner city, wasn't my label, and it wasn't all that I was, and I wasn't powerless, that I was powerful. Too often, those dynamics are labeled as powerless. So yeah, I went to college. I graduated with honors. I won the President's Cup for Leadership. I went on and got my PhD at 26. But working that way made me see the world differently. I'm afraid that too many of the folks that I know who volunteer with folks who don't look like them, it's the only time that they're interacting with people who don't look like them. And they're interacting in a position where it's not an equal partnership. It's those people I'm helping, those poor people need me. And it puts them in a place. And yes, of course, they say, by the end of the day, I realized I needed them because... But it puts you in a position where you don't really see people and you don't really know people. And if the only time you interact with someone outside of yourself who doesn't look like you or your family is when you're handing somebody a sandwich, then you don't know people outside of your group. And it's time that we look further and we look beyond and we get involved in some activities and some places and things that take us outside of ourselves, but also change that power dynamic where if you're the one who's always in need, then you're suddenly needed. And when if you're the one who thinks you're needed, you're suddenly the one in need. I love you. And I know we're going to get there. And we all have these beautiful experiences within us that we need to awaken to see. You have the tools. I love you.